Can you feel it? Can you feel it? Can you feel it?
The first player I'm going to be talking about today is none other than Tank Younger. Tank Younger from Grambling State University, Grambling, Louisiana. What's up? I'm going to show you guys some love, talk about your college a little bit in the videos. Man, I love it. I love it. I love it. Man, the first channel I want to say welcome. 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 Tank Younger. Man, first black HBCU player ever to go. He also won a championship in 1951 with the LA Rams. Tank Younger ran for 3,640 yards in his career on 770 attempts, 34 touchdowns. He caught 100 passes for 1,167 yards. He was also a four-time Pro Bowler. So, he actually had a really good career for his time. I have a video, a little clip with him talking about his experience with some of his teammates. It's pretty good, actually, with him being the first black player. He was a big man for his size, too. When you look at the video, you'll see how much bigger he was than some of the actual players that he played against. But I'm going to be doing a little talking about Grambling State. Grambling State, it's in Louisiana. It's in the boot. Home of Eddie Robinson, the famous black HBCU coach, Doug Williams. The first black quarterback to win the NFL championship, Willis Reed. Man, they had a lot of good people to come from Grambling. Ronnie Coleman, Erica Badu. But Grambling State developed from an African-American farmer's place, actually. It was an African-American farmer's place in North Louisiana. They wanted to educate other African Americans. So in 1901, it was called Color Industrial and Agricultural College. So in 1928, it was also the North Louisiana Agricultural and Industrial Field. It changed their name a lot throughout the years. In 1928, the school also offered a two-year degree and certification. In 1936, the name was changed to the Louisiana Negro Normal and Industrial Institute. It had its first bachelor program, was awarded in 1944. In 1946, it changed its name to Grambling College. So the name has changed, especially with a lot of HBCUs. They were different names. Their name actually changed a lot. So in 2010, it was they added a 16th building to the college, and it was added to the National Register of Historical Places. So a lot of the HBCUs, as we're going to review on this channel, are historical places because of their contribution to society. But like I said, my channel was actually created, man. I just want to encourage young people, man. Use sports. Get your education. Because as you know, injuries happen. Things happen. unfortunately, you know, one injury could just mess up your whole career. So just use sports to get your education, get you something to fall back on. Because I was actually doing some stats, and I know, you know, a lot of people don't know, but some people might know that actually 1.6% of players actually make it to the league. 1.6. That is really, really low. And they actually only invite 350 players to the NFL Combine. So, like I said, use your education, you know, have something to fall back on, because, you know, you never know what can happen. But as long as you have that education, you can always get you a career in that field of your degree. And that's actually what I wanted my channel to be about, man. I want people to understand, you know, especially my African-American brothers and sisters, you know, that you can actually...
You can actually education.
Do it through education.
Sports is a way out.
Sports is a way out.
Rap is a way out.
None of that. So yeah, use it, man. Hey, let's jam. Oh, yes. Hey. I forgot I put this song in here, guys. Hey. Hey. Eddie Robinson, the great coach Eddie Robinson, has a museum named after him as well. One of the best coaches in just period. I was going to say HBCU, but just overall as a coach, Eddie Robinson is actually one of the best coaches ever. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. All the colors of the world. So, yes, yes, yes. I hope you guys can feel it. I want it to be big, you know. I actually want to do interviews with some of the former players, you know, because, like I say, as you learn, I learn. And the reason why I picked to do HBCUs is, you know, I'm from the South. You know, I was born in Flowood, Mississippi, grew up 14 years in Jackson, then moved to Houston. You know, now I stay in Denver, but all of my family was HBCU alumni. My dad went to Jackson State, played with Walter Payton, blocked for Walter Payton, actually. Jackie Slayer was on the offensive line, so I actually met them because we used to go to the games on the weekend, you know, when we stayed in Jackson. You know, a brother went to Alcorn. I know Steve McNair. Sister went to Pearview. Like, everybody in my family, auntie, uncles, just HBCU, just crazy. And, you know, I love it. And they have some of the best fans, the best alumni, you know, but the thing is that I noticed with HBCUs is that, you know, the Power Five conferences, the bigger schools, their alumni gave so much money that really kind of put them out the picture as far as talent. Because in the 50s, 60s, and 70s, like, all your talent, most of your Hall of Fame players came from HBCU. So we have some images of Tate Younger here that I took off the internet. They was actually in the only places I can get them, you know, and I did research. I tried. So here's a video we have.
The Browns kicked off, and Vitamin Smith, taking the ball back, reflected some of the key spirit of the game.